Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter photosynthesis. In that we are studying topic phosphorylation or photophosphorylation. When I say photophosphorylation, it means formation of ATP, or you can say breakdown of ATP. ATP to ADP and then AMP. Now from 3 to 2 to 1. How does that happen? We'll be studying that today. Photophosphorylation. It is a process of ATP synthesis. ATP is made. ATP is adenosine triphosphate, the main energy molecule. Whenever there is a reaction inside a body, ATP is needed as a main energy source. For example, when you're hungry and you need energy to do work, you eat food. Similarly, when cells have to do any function, they need energy molecules, which are ATP. And now when you take ATP, the full form of ATP is adenosine triphosphates. So example, you have one ATP and you have used it in some energy. So from that energy molecule, if you use one phosphate, ATP becomes ADP, that is adenosine diphosphate. Again, you have used one phosphate, then ATP becomes AMP, that is adenosine monophosphate. So this is how ATP is broken down. Now, how does that process happens of ATP breaking down? Whenever light falls on photosystems, when I say photosystems, remember chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B, carotenoids, xanthophyll present inside the grana. Yes, they were photosystem or LHC or light harvesting molecules, which have ability to absorb sunlight. So when light falls on photosystems, the reaction center absorbs some amount of sunlight. Example, we are talking about pigment system 1. So the reaction center of pigment system 1 was 680. So when light will fall on pigment system 1, the reaction center will absorb energy which is equivalent to 680. Now once it has absorbed the energy equivalent to 680 in the form of photons, electrons get excited. And these electrons, once they are excited from the ground state, they jump to higher level state. Electrons, they move from the nucleus, that is the nearby position, and grow to the primary acceptor. When I say primary acceptor, it means the first acceptor. And then they pass to the second acceptor, third acceptor, and so on and so forth. Now this works like a chain until unless they reach to the last acceptor. And as electrons in the form of photons move towards different acceptor, the formation of ATP and NADP takes place. In PS1, there are certain acceptors that accept electrons, which are in cyclic process. Whereas in PS2, there are different set of electron acceptors which help in the formation of ATP or NADPH. Basic aim of this photophosphorylation is to generate maximum amount of ATP and NADPH, which is nicotinamide adenine phosphates, so that they can be used in the dark reaction of photosynthesis. You all know that dark reaction of photosynthesis uses ATP and NADPH from the light reaction. Photophosphorylation. Photo means sunlight and phosphorylation means breakage or breakdown. Basically, the process of photophosphorylation is ATP synthesis. How ATP from adenosine triphosphate gets converted into ADP, that is adenosine diphosphate, and then into AMP, that is adenosine monophosphate. This process takes place in photosystems. The process of photophosphorylation starts with when light or photon energy from sun falls on photosystems. Next, the reaction center absorbs particular wavelength of sunlight. Example, 680 nanometers. If the reaction center has an ability of 680 nanometers. In the third step, electrons get excited. That is, if an electron is present in its lower shell or near the nucleus, once it absorbs energy, the electron will jump to the higher shell. And this jump of electron is due to the excited electron. In the next step, electron move away from the nucleus, then it goes to the first primary acceptor. It could be cytochrome B, cytochrome F, whatever, depending upon the photosystem. Then electrons are passed through series of electron acceptors, the same electron acceptors which are present in photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. At the end of this process, that is at the end of cyclic photophosphorylation and non-cyclic photophosphorylation, ATP is made, which could be used, or probably which is used in the dark reaction or the C3 cycle or the Kelvin cycle. So students, I hope you all are clear about the concept of photophosphorylation. Thank you.